Hi, and welcome to Dynamic Tennis Method. In my last video, I showed you how to use the tip, skip, and whip technique to hit a perfect forehand ground stroke. In this video, we're gonna use that exact same technique to hit two other kinds of shots for a total of three shots using only one technique. Let's jump in. Now, the shot that I showed you in the last video is struck after the ball bounces and right before it bounces a second time. There's two moments where the ball passes through that exact same contact point, and that is before its first bounce and directly after its first bounce. Now, if I were to break down the timing of all three shots to rhythmic counts, the shot that's hit after the bounce on the fall will be 1, 2, 3. To hit a shot before the first bounce on the fall, I would simply shuffle on 1, contact on 2. For the on the rise shot, which is hit just after the bounce, I'll use the same coordination and I'll just follow it through just a bit later than I would, so it would be 2E, to borrow a musical term. Then move on to shadow strokes. It's important that you don't do the stroke in slow motion, nor do you push through the shot quickly. Now, if you really want this to work, you've got to relax. Hold onto the racket as loose as possible. While you're learning, you can even drop the pinky off the edge of your racket. Do the count as rhythmically as possible and really allow gravity to do the work. The next step is to try it with a self-feed. It's important that when you toss the ball to yourself, you do it in a way that'll complement your stroke. You don't want to toss the ball by throwing it down like this. What you want to do instead is you want to float the ball in front of you so that you can also float or shuffle along with the ball. Try hitting the ball on the fall after the bounce. And then once you get the hang of it, try hitting the ball before the ball's bounce. Skip right as you toss your feed. For the on the rise shot, you want to shuffle with the feet just as you would with the on the fall before the bounce, hitting it just after 2. Once you get the hang of it, you can try it with a partner or a coach, progressively moving further and further away to a controlled rally. So that's it, how to hit three shots with only one technique. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to use the same rhythmic timing, the same relaxation, the same dropped swing to hit a one-handed backhand with more ease and efficiency than you ever thought possible. I hope you'll come and join us. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.